Welcome to How It Works, a video series from Law Sites and Law Next, in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from the developers. In today's episode, we're going to take a look at NeosAI, recently released software from Assembly that empowers law firms to harness AI-powered intelligence effortlessly directly within the Neos case management platform, so there's no disruption to established workflows. Joining me today to tell us all about NeosAI and show us how it works is Bryan, Vice President, Customer Education. Bryan, welcome to the program.
Hello, sir. Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Great to have you. Why don't we kick it off before we get into the demonstration with your telling us a little bit about Neos and about NeosAI.
Okay. So Neos is a cloud-based case management platform, and I'm going to get to NeosAI in a second. It's really cool stuff, but there's a lot of history in our product and our company. Assembly software was born out of the combination of Needles and Trialworks. So you've been around the industry like me for a while and are familiar with those names as well. Needles was formed in 1985. So we're coming up on our 40th anniversary as a software entity. And I mean, I challenge you to name a 40-year-old software company besides like IBM and Microsoft. So we've been doing it for a long time. We've been working in the space for a long time. And Neos is the result of all of that expertise that's come through Needles and Trialworks. And all of the wonderful new talent we've been able to bring on board with Assembly. NeosAI is just the latest and greatest new addition to that platform. So we're pretty excited about it.
And you launched it, I think, in June. Do you want to dive in, show us how it works?
Absolutely. So let's go ahead and share my screen here, and we will click all the right buttons to do this perfectly the first try. Tell me if you see what I see.
I see what you see.
Awesome. All right. So welcome to Neos. I could spend five of our interview sessions going through cool stuff in Neos. But yes, we're going to focus specifically on NeosAI today. And there's a lot been said about artificial intelligence in the legal space lately. I have what I believe to be a somewhat unique perspective in that it's a tool. Just like anything else, it's a tool. It's a tool to be utilized by attorneys and case managers and paralegals, no different than document templates and e-signatures and digital medical records and all these other tools that come through. You don't need to be scared of it. You just need to use it intelligently and appropriately. So I'm going to show you three ways to do that today with NeosAI. We're going to cover document summary, document generation, and then my favorite, document extraction. So let's start with document summary. I'm going to go to a case here, and this is a very simple, just getting started auto accident case for Sue Storm. So the way Neos is laid out is this is my case, and my data is broken up into these different tabs. I've got information on my parties, the case, companion cases, the checklist to track all of your task management. But what we're going to be focused on today is documents, and I don't even have any documents in here yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag in a new document, and we're going to call this an authorization, and we are going to analyze it with NeosAI as we upload it. So what this document is it's just a classic retainer agreement. My client, I sent them a retainer agreement, they sent it back, but it's like 8 or 9 pages. So law firms are getting documents and data all the time, and sometimes they're voluminous, they're big, they're technical. So as you can see, Neos, what it has done is as I've uploaded the document, it saved it for me to access, to click, to view, so I can see it whenever I want to see it. But what it also did is it created a nice, clean little summary for me. So if I go into the details of the document here and I scroll down, in one paragraph, it says, okay, you've got a 9-page document, but I'm going to summarize it down to a bite size for you so you can tell at a glance what's included in this document. Now, there's two summaries here. The first is the overview, which is what I've highlighted first, and that's just that one paragraph from 9 pages, so you get the gist. The second is the document details. And what it's done is it's taken out what it believes to be the crucial parts of the document word for word. So one of them is a summary and the other is just like, okay, these were the key bullet points in this document. This is going to save you a lot of time when you're either trying to figure out which document you're looking for, or you've got something coming in and you want a quick summary to understand what was sent to your firm. I still recommend actually reading the document. It doesn't replace your legal knowledge and expertise, but what it does is it expedites your process so that you get what you need very quickly. That's the concept of document summary. Any questions on that one, Bob?
One question I have, Bryan, is if I've gotten in a very lengthy document, and maybe I want a little bit more detailed of a summary or a little less detailed of a summary, do I have any control over how detailed the summary is going to be?
So not at this stage. We are on the Microsoft platform. Everything we do sits on Microsoft. Azure, OneDrive, we're tightly integrated with Outlook for your email and your calendar. So we use Microsoft's AI tools, which are absolutely best in class. There are some areas that I'm going to show you next where you've got the ability to customize a little bit on the generation side, but on the summary, we want to make it as quick and easy for you as possible. This is the gist, and by all means, read the big one, but this will allow you to see which document you're looking at and what's contained therein.
Great, thank you.
Awesome. All right, so let's take the next step for document generation. And this is what people are typically thinking of when they're thinking AI. This is the ChatGPT. I ask it to do this, I ask it to do that, and it generates something for me. This case is very simple, and it doesn't have a lot here yet. So I'm going to switch to a very filled out case with lots of tabs, lots of data, value items, all sorts of things going on. We're going to go back to that documents tab. We're going to generate with NeosAI, and we're going to generate a demand letter. And the reason I like using a demand letter is because it's a perfect example of I need data from all over the place. Now, here's where you were talking about options. So I can choose a tone, and if it's a demand letter, I'm always going to choose demanding. I am not a casual or less demanding attorney. I am a demanding attorney, but I'm also going to choose a short length here. And this is broken down into sections. I'm going to get this thing going so we can take a look at it in a minute. But while this is thinking, I want to show you what it's doing. There's five different sections in this demand letter. The introduction, the demand facts and liability, the damages, the injuries and treatments, as well as the actual demand settlement. And you can see the stuff is starting to pop in. But what it's also telling me is where it's pulling the information from. So I've got this case with all of this data. So it's pulling in case data, insurance data, party data, our firm data for our firm information. It's really powerful in that it's going to comb through your entire case and pull out all of that cool content. Now I have the ability to review each section. So now it's finished generating all five sections and I can go through and say, okay, this looks good. I like this. How are we looking on this section? All right, that looks okay. But if I want, I can specifically set different things. Like let's say in my injuries and treatment, I want it to specifically call out these insurance carriers that are associated with the case. And then if I look through, it looks like some of the treatment dates aren't here. So I have this additional instruction section where I can actually type physical, what was it? Therapy session took place on, we'll say the same date there. And we'll spell therapy correctly because there's always pressure to type when somebody's watching. And I'm going to click generate, and it's going to think about this again for a second. All right. So what it did is it went out and it grabbed the information that I was looking for. And then with the instructions that I typed, actually thought about it and transitioned that into text form. So if I go through all of these different sections and everything looks good, I click generate documents and it's going to give me a warning, which is the same warning that I was providing to you a moment ago. This is AI, and it is a tool, and it is very powerful. It does not have a law degree. It is not a paralegal. So we're going to generate this document for you, but we recommend strongly that when it's done, you take a look. And so now that we've made all those choices, the actual generating of the document is very quick. And this is our demand letter saved right into our case. And it's multiple pages. It's pulling from all the different areas of the program. It's got all of the different classic things that you would expect from a demand letter, all generated automatically with your choices using AI.
Bryan, when you brought up the original form to create the demand letter, the data sources were filled in. Is that something you did in advance, or does it do that automatically, and can you modify those?
So we set up what we think are probably the best choices for you. When you're talking about actual numbers and money, we're going to pull from the value tab. If you're talking about like injuries, we're going to pull from the medical records. That said, you are welcome to add, remove, change in any way that you like. So we've taken kind of our company's best guess at what we think will work best for you, but given you the freedom to make any modifications you like.
So I could go in, drop down, and find the data sources I want, or I could delete data sources that you have.
Absolutely. It's very simple to tweak and give it those instructions via the data sources, or literally just written instructions. Go get this, pull that in, add this, because I think it would be helpful to the document.
Right. I really like that. I like the fact that it does it in sections, because it gives you control over the different types of data for the different types of sections.
Exactly. It can get a little overwhelming if you're trying to do everything at once, so it's kind of piecemeal. And the last thing I want to point out here for document generation, but is applicable for all the NEOS AI features, this is all built into NEOS. There isn't a third party, there isn't another entity, this isn't, you know, passing through some other company. This is all packaged directly into NEOS and utilizing those Microsoft tools that we have at our disposal.
Great.
All right. You ready for the next one? Because this one's my
favorite.
Ready. All right. So we're going to go back to our simple case here where we're just getting started. And the third thing that we're going to talk about is document extraction. Document generation is very cool and very shiny and popular, and that's what everybody talks about. But I think, in my opinion, the thing that's really going to save people time is consuming documents that are sent to the firm instead of generating them out. You have so much stuff coming in. So I'm uploading an invoice from a hospital. And again, I'm going to analyze and I'm going to save. And while NEOS AI is analyzing this document, I'm going to show you what it looks like. So simple invoice I put together. This is our client. This is the hospital. And I've got these different line items and a total. Simple stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if I go back, NEOS has already done analyzing it, and we're going to open up the details of this file, and it's going to have extracted all of the key information. So we have the client's name and address. We have the vendor, the provider that we call in NEOS, so the name of the hospital, their address, and I have individual line items for each medical charge that was associated with that invoice. Here's where it gets really cool. Because AI can do a lot of things for you that are flashy, but what's important is when it's functional. How is this actually going to be helpful to me? How is it actually going to save me time and therefore money for my law firm? Here's the button. Create value records. Value is what we refer to any type of money in a case in NEOS. And what it's going to do is it's going to take all of those items. I can do them individually, or I can do them as just one line item. And these are medical expenses. It's already given me the provider because it pulled it from the invoice. And we click save. And what it's done is it's taken that invoice that we got from the hospital and put it right in the case's value tab with all of the information there. So now me nor my staff has to spend time entering all this in, typing the name of the hospital, their address, the date, the different line items, the total balance, none of it. Upload, NEOS AI extracts the data and then puts it in a useful place so that you can see what the details are. And if you go to document generation and you want to generate a demand letter, guess what it's going to look at? The content that was created with data extraction, these value tab numbers, in order to make sure that your client receives credit for every dollar that's appropriate.
Which goes back to generating that demand letter.
You got it. So, like I said at the beginning, AI is a tool, and it is a very powerful one. We at Assembly have spent a lot of time and worked really hard to really think about how to utilize those AI tools and bake it into the system so it's helpful in the actual workflows that a law firm does every day.
Bryan, I know there's a lot more to all of this that we don't have time to look at today. So people who are watching this, how can they find out more about Neos AI or Neos in general?
That is a fabulous question. Very simple. Assemblysoftware.com. Head over to our website. There's lots of information here. There's lots of resources. There's on-demand webinars and demonars and all sorts of things. But there's also a way to just sign up and get your very own demo where they will go a lot farther than I was able to do today.
Well, Bryan, thanks so much. It's been really interesting and I enjoyed talking with you.
Bob, it was a pleasure. Thank you for making time for us today. I really appreciate it.
And that does it for this episode of How It Works. You can find the full series at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab, and we're also up on YouTube under How It Works. This is Bob Ambrogi. Thanks for watching today.
Bye, everybody.